So the stock market is just a compilation of publicly held or publicly open companies that allows for you to buy equity or shares of ownership with their company. So the S&P 500 is pretty much an index of all of the top 500 publicly held companies in America from coast to coast. And usually when people need funding, the very first thing they do, they raise money and give equity in their inside their company because they don't have to promise any money back. So the stock market is an open place for you to be able to have ownership of these companies that are across the country.
And so with the stock market, how risky is it? You know, is it a risk? Because is it like gambling? You know, what's the difference between, I guess, putting your money in the stock market and gambling?
It's the same because people's mindsets are the same. And the reason why I say it's the same because people's mindsets are the same is because everyone's trying to make quick dollars. Proverbs 13:11 says, "Wealth gained hastily, you lose it just as fast, but wealth gathered little by little grows over time." And people aren't investing in companies because they've done the research. They're not investing in companies because they want to be a part of that company long term. They're literally just investing in companies to make a quick come up or to make a quick flip. And everyone has a flipping mentality and not an investing mentality. The stock market would be a good place to invest your money after you have secured the safety of the majority of your cash flow, which is why we talk about what the banks do with their money. And they don't put money in the stock market like we do. And if we want to become the bank and we want to do things like the bank, we can actually mimic the bank. And actually, can you bring that up on the screen?
What's that?
The bank?
Let's go.
They
Let's
can
do
see
it.
your screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to show you where the banks put their money, and then it'll allow for you to kind of have some idea of why we teach what we teach, because the banks teach you, because what we have to understand is that the banking institution is what is what backs the stock market. Every transaction happens. So you're going to go to the FDIC.gov. FDIC.gov. They can see the screen. .gov. He put like glove. That's how you know you're a hooper. He trying to spell.
All right.
So at the FDIC.gov.
Now he's saying glove.
I want you to go where it says deposit insurance. And let me tell you, go to bank find. And we're showing you publicly so you can do it yourself. And because typically what we tell people, let's just stop right here. Because typically what we tell people is this. You know, when Brother Ben and I are typically talking. When Brother Ben and I are typically talking, we're talking from a place where we can actually back up what we're talking about through facts, research, and knowledge. So there's a lot of people who try to combat what I say, but they don't. They bring me opinions and no numbers. So I'm gonna show you guys real quick where the banks actually put their money. But one thing I want you to understand is that if you want to be able to achieve success, you have to have the right mindset in order to do it. And if you want to do it, I'm gonna show you where the banks actually put their money. We're gonna talk about why they encourage us to actually put our monies in the stock market. Here in a second. Okay. So let's get to it. So where it says institution name, you see where it says institution name. Let's
right
ask
here.
The people. Let's ask the people. Go back so we can see somebody who's watching. Give us a bank that you want us to search.
Anybody. We got 137 people on here.
Give us a bank that you want us to search.
Just name any bank that you bank with that you want us to look up to see where they put their money.
Give us a bank that you want us to search.
They may be a little bit behind. So we're going to wait on y'all to just give us one bank. Throw a bank out there, family.
When y'all catch up. Because, you know, I'd rather just prove it, Brother Ben. Not
Somebody said Navy, Federal, Credit Union, Chase.
Let's do Chase. We have two people that said Chase. So we're going to do it with a private institution. We're going to type in Chase. And we're going to see where the banks actually. That's it. Just put search. We're going to look up the what. Where they actually put their money. So you're going to click where it says 628,
628.
JP Morgan. Yep. So they tell us to put our money in the stock market, Brother Ben. They also tell us to put our money in the savings accounts. Let's see where the banks actually put their money.
Okay, here we go.
So as you guys can see, just highlight up there where it says March 3rd, 2020. So that what's today's date, Brother Ben?
Today's date is the 5th.
Oh, so that was 2 days ago, right?
Yep.
So let's click generate report. And what you guys are, what we, what,
where is that at?
To the right, right there.
Right here.
Down
right
below.
Here, right here, y'all. Generate report.
Click generate report. So we're going to park there parenthetically, like Freddie Haynes says. Right? Don't scroll down. No, you ready? You ready to show them something, Brother Ben? Let's stay for a second. What we got to understand is that the FDIC is actually backed by taxpayers' dollars. So when you see your bank that says that it's backed by the FDIC, it's actually backed by us, the taxpayers. So anything that is backed by the public has to be publicly known or publicly seen. So we're going to go look at it for ourselves. Go ahead and click to it. And so what we're looking at right now, not yet now. It says JP Morgan Chase Bank National Association. Everybody can see that. And so what we're going to do, Brother Ben, we're actually going to see where the banks actually put their money. You may want to make your screen bigger so that people can see it.
I think that's the biggest it
gets. Okay. Not over here. If you click, go there and then click there and then click. Yep. Let's make it bigger so that they can actually see it. And what we're looking at their assets and liabilities ledger. We're looking up their assets and liabilities ledger. So most financial advisors are telling you to put 100% of your money in a 401k, put all of your money in the stock market, because that's what successful people do. Mm-hmm. And most of the people that are financial advisors, they make money off you putting your money in the stock market. So I can understand them trying to sway you to do exactly what they teach. But what I've learned, Brother Ben, is that information that has become readily available is typically the wrong information. Ask yourself, has my identity about who I am, has that been made readily available for me, or have I had to research who the black man was in order for me to come into the knowledge of who I am? And so information that is readily available for us is probably the wrong information. So let's keep showing proof, Brother Ben. Let's document. And so what we're looking at, before you go, this is the assets and liabilities ledger. So I want you to highlight where it says dollar figures in thousands. This right here is letting us know that any number that we see, we have to add 3 zeros to the number. Any number that we see, we have to add 3 zeros to the number. So, Brother Ben, can you go to line 28? As you guys can see, I do this every day, so this is why I know exactly
line
where
28.
Line 28 of this assets and liabilities ledger.
Right here.
Line 28. Highlight the whole thing all the way to $2 billion. So stop. Just this right there, the $2 billion. Okay. So right there. What you doing, brother?
Trying to just highlight.
Just highlight one right there. So as that says, add 3 zeros. That says that the bank puts $2 billion in common stock. Mm-hmm. Now, I know some of them, Brother Ben, see that, brother? He just contradicted himself. He said, don't put your money in stocks like that. Banks don't do it. And look what the bank's done. The banks put $2 billion in there. And Brother Ben, $2 billion seems like a lot when you don't have anything to compare it to. So if you don't have anything to compare it to, it seems like a lot. And Brother Ben, I like to compare that to basketball. So if you see somebody hooping at the YMCA and they beating up on people that's never played basketball before, you'll say, man, that person's good. But if that person were to play me one-on-one, you're going to be like, man, that person really sucks, because you're comparing it to something. You're comparing it as a marker of comparison. So line 28, it says that Chase Banks put $2 billion inside common stock. Now go to line 41 for me, Brother Ben. Let's look at another asset ledger. However, it looks like the banks actually put $11 billion in life insurance reserves. Wait a minute. Now, Brother Ben, they told us to put all of our money in Wall Street, right? Mm-hmm. But the banks are putting literally seven times more money inside of insurance reserves, cash reserves, than they are actually in common stock. Brother Ben, let's go back. Let's try another bank, because I'm trying to prove something. Everybody wants to get on Wall Street because they want to flip bread. And what you don't understand is that you never build a house, Brother Ben. You never build a house without a strong foundation. Let's go back another one. Let's pick another bank.
Okay, I seen somebody say they want to do Bank of America.
Oh, click Bank of America. Let's type in Bank of America. Bank of America been hiding from me because they know I've been searching their stuff. Go scroll down. Let's type in Bank of America. Let's look up Bank of America's assets. Uh-oh, 3510. Welcome back. Look at their ledger. Go to generate report. Yes, sir. Let's go to line 28. Line 28, highlight for the people. Common Bank stock. Of America puts $3 billion in common stock. Bank of America, you got to add three zeros to the number. It says that in the instructions. So Bank of America puts $3 billion in common stock. Let's see how much money they put in life insurance reserves.
What line is that?
Line 41.
Line 41. Boom.
They put $22 billion in life insurance reserves and only $3 billion in stock market, Brother Ben. That's, I can't do the math, but that's seven times more money in life insurance reserves than they actually put in, Brother Ben, than they actually put in common stock. Well, that got me conflicted, Brother Ben. The question that they should be asking me is, Jake, for one, what's this got to do with the stock market, everything? And two, I'm looking at the blueprint of the industries that run America. I don't want to listen to a financial advisor. I want to mimic the very industries that are funding the financial advisors, not what the financial advisors are telling me.